When hunting for bass, you first want to locate structures. Structures are physical aspects shaped by the environment, such as drop-offs, creek channels, flats, humps, and points that can normally be found in changes of depth or shape of the lake bed. Bass will orientate themselves around structures and use them to navigate between points, so they're good to use when selecting your. An overhead cast is ideal for performing long-range casts. The cast power will start increasing once you begin casting. This line represents the furthest you can cast. You should aim to release the cast before this line, depending on how far you want to cast. When you apply too much power to your cast, the power meter will go red. This will affect your casting distance and accuracy. This will start reeling in your line. While fishing, you can increase or decrease the rate your line is reeled in by adjusting your reel speed. You can switch between all your rods so long as you're within close proximity of your rod stand. You will want to use different casting styles based on the desired casting distance. You can switch between the casting methods anytime before committing to a cast. All casts are executed using the same control method. When fighting a fish, you need to manage the tension on the line. Too low or too high, and you're in danger of losing the fish. The drag system can be adjusted to increase or decrease the resistance on the line. If you set the drag system to its maximum, the fish won't be able to pull line from the reel at all, but this will put more tension on your line. If you set it to its lowest setting, the fish will pull the line out easily and swim further away. This will put less tension on your line. Keep the pressure on and eventually the fish will tire out, making it easier to reel in. You can also increase or release pressure as well as guide the fish by moving the rod while reeling. This icon shows that the fish is exhausted and ready.